These vehicles here are being loaded as part of Exercise Black Eagle, a bilateral UK and Polish exercise. It's described by the Army as a significant demonstration of the UK's support to the region and NATO's immediate assurance measures. Just last week, the King's Royal Hussars main battle tank, the Challenger 2, began its journey. KRH is the lead armoured battle group and during the exercise will form the UK's biggest armoured deployment in Eastern Europe since 2008.
We're looking at deploying 30 guys to Mönchengladbach in the middle of October, where they'll be taking over the 11 tanks which have been in storage there since the middle of the Iraq War. So that poses a lot of challenges in getting that fleet fit and ready to use. These tanks will meet them down there, and then the whole fleet as one will get loaded onto trains to the railhead in Mönchengladbach and spend up to a week moving across Germany and Poland to the training area, and hopefully meet us there in one piece.
Today, though, it's all about the move of the Warrior, provided by 1st Battalion, the Royal Welsh. And making all of this possible is the Royal Logistic Corps. They're using the world's most powerful tank transporter, a multi-wheel truck and trailer which can move a 72-tonne load.
The skill needed to drive one of these safely is unbelievable. Unbelievable. The lads, they have to be switched on at all times to make sure they're aware of the size of the vehicle. They also have to drive for the other people on the road, because not everyone knows that the steering at the back of the trailer, it's going to turn out when they go around corners.
Moving the heavy armour is 19 Tank Transporter Regiment, RLC, based in Bulford Garrison, the only unit in the British Army that can carry out this kind of heavy load move.
It is a big task and the guys have worked extremely hard. It is, you know, it can be pressuring towards the guys because there's not that many guys compared to how much kit there is. So to man the trucks, everything else, they're working immensely hard.
And it looks actually quite dangerous as well.
No, these guys are very well trained, extremely well trained. Obviously, we've got a lot of policies in place. Their safeties are paramount. And getting the loads on, the drivers, everybody are absolutely paramount. So they're trained. They go on a very long course, 7 weeks on their A3, and they get trained to the highest standard and then gain the experience out on the roads.
And what strikes me about the whole of this is it would not be possible without the expertise.
Absolutely not, no. And that's exactly what it is expertise on how to deal with the kit and equipment, because everything's different. Everything's got its own way of being loaded, being secured and being looked after whilst in transit on the road to its final destination.
There's still some way to go, though, to get the Army's heavy metal to their end location. The next step, the military port of Marchwood in Hampshire, where they'll cross the water to make their way into Poland. Shirley Swain, Forces News, Tidworth in Wiltshire.